Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're heading for the... what is it? Cradle? The something cradle? System? Track down the Blue Suns. Oh, so Rosetta Nebula is completely complete! Get fueled up here. And we're on our way. Last episode we did Jacob's loyalty quest. So he's now completely loyal. Sigurd's Cradle, to disable the false signal that draws in ships like the MSV Strontium Mule. Although they kinda deserved it with a name like that, maybe. Planting false Skepsis? Planting false, distress signals. So ships come to aid and are attacked, slaughtered, and hijacked. Makes me think of Skexies from the Dark Crystal series. If anyone was wondering why the hell I was doing that. Wallace, wow. An unusually small Pegasid or hot Jupiter, Wallace was originally an extrasolar planet that entered this system and was captured by the gravity well of the G-class star Skepsis. Tidally locked, Wallace's hot side reaches temperatures over 2500 degrees Celsius. While not large enough, proportionate to the star to cause eclipses visible from Watson, it is easily seen at dawn or dusk as one of the brightest objects in the sky. We have moderate results. We want some palladium and element zero. And that's not quite enough palladium. Maybe this, I can get this higher over here. What was it? Kinda lost the palladium here. Yeah, no biggie. There's a lot of platinum on board. Oh. You're getting fleeting glimpses a little bit there. There's not really a lot. I mean, it'll take a large spike, but yeah, never mind. Wallace, huh? Darwin, cool. A mid-sized rock planet, Darwin is ironically named, being one of the worst places for life in the galaxy. Its atmosphere is punishing, its temperature boiling, its chemical makeup toxic. Carbon monoxide and methane wrap this planet in an unyielding haze, and scans of its surface show only silicates and molten tin. Its daily thermal fluctuations lead to hurricane-level vortices, two at each pole, forming eyes that can be seen from orbit. Despite all this, Darwin is still used by spacers as a drive core discharge point. Hydrogen pierces the clouds in the upper atmosphere, making for a relatively benign approach. All this info here, and bloop. And we have good results. Nice.
Launching probe.
Pretty good.
Launching probe.
Some bonus iridium there. We have so much iridium, my god. There's a little bit there, yeah. Okay. So I wonder what else we're gonna be named after here. Sir Isaac Newton? Watson. Watson is known in human media for two things. Its particular spectacular times brought on by a large moon and the bureaucratic snafu over which Earth nations got to settle there first. Watson is a garden world first discovered in 2165 CE. With credit claimed by the Chinese People's Federation, the United North American States, and the European Union. The Systems Alliance brokered the infamous Reykjavik Compromise, allowing limited colonization from each coalition in cities comprised of populations from each nation. Watson itself trends colder than Earth, with the temperate zone measuring about 30 degrees latitude in either direction from the equator. Its life does not easily map to Earth's evolutionary eras. Some islands have species that resemble terrestrial placental mammals. Others are overrun by arthropods. It is estimated that at least two more generations of xenozoologists will be needed to properly classify all of the species of the planet. Stuff. Good results. Oh, look at all that palladium there.
Probe away.
Started right off on that. That was awesome. Oh, what? Element zero, nice. Always a treat when we find that.
Probe launched.
I think I could have gotten a little bit higher, but that's alright.
Probe.
Some more. Wonder if we can break 70k on that. That'd be cool. Oh, awesomes!
Launching probe.
We did it! 70k iridium. It was a long time before we even had a third this much.
Launching probe.
What? Forgot I'm also looking for what? Here we go. I'm also looking for palladium. There's some over there somewhere.
Away.
Wait, here we go.
Probe launched.
A little bit more and I'll be done. As long as we get over 100k, I am satisfied. I wonder if I'll ever reach that amount with the element zero.
Launching probe.
Seems possible. I think it's like 75k now. Almost. If it can be done, we will do it.
Probe launched.
Now we're just looking for the Ezo. Ease off the Ezo, man. No, pour on the Ezo. Alright, I guess that's good. Yeah. Good find right there. Elementary, my dear Watson. And Crick. Is there someone named Crick in Earth history as well? Known for its spectacular geysers that can be seen from orbit, Crick is a rock planet with expansive frozen oceans. Though it is within the temperature and pressure range for human habitation, its thick atmosphere is largely carbon dioxide and monoxide, making breath masks or environmental suits mandatory. The most abundant resources for exploitation are the potassium salts found in its seabeds, which fetch good prices on terraforming worlds. It is rich in stuff, but I only want element zero. No, I do not want to launch a probe right now. Denied. It looks like you might get a tiny bit of ESO there, but I'm not sure. Definitely a large spikes of resources on this planet, but I don't think there's ESO. 57%. We're missing... Ah! Oh, we got two more planets, wow. Pauling. A hydrogen methane gas giant, Pauling's gravitational field is believed to have cleared most of what would otherwise have been a sizable asteroid belt. The 2163 mission of the space probe Ultimate gave the inhabitants of Watson reams of data reinforcing this theory, giving the colonists an accurate count of its moons, which are 66 of them, rings, moon-like ring objects, and more than 200 impact craters on the surface of its metallic core. Ultimate has been since retrieved for reuse on subsequent missions within the solar system. Poor results. How sad. No. I think we're good here. And I think this is the last one. Kimowitz. Named for the 21st century pioneer of groundwater remediation techniques, Kimowitz is an impressive layer of ice over a stony metallic core. Despite its size, it has only one moon, NOAA, which shares its carbonaceous composition, leading astronomers to believe it formed following a giant impact. Iridium deposits have attracted miners to the planet who must work through robots and telepresence because of the planet's strong gravity. And it's freaking cold here, 190 degrees Celsius. So that could also be a reason why they use robots to mine here. Definitely seeing the iridium, among other things. But no element zero, so... Yeah, I think we're done here. 85. Okay, I guess we're not done. But, oh, we got this little moon here. Oh, the moon of Watson? Okay.
Anomaly detected.
Anomaly detected on Franklin. Dr. Franklin from Babylon 5. A large moon, Franklin retains a trace atmosphere of carbon dioxide, but its desolate surface holds no signs of water or life. In order to defend Watson from the pirates of the Terminus systems, Franklin is home to two Alliance spaceports, and naval bases capable of fielding 6 fighter squadrons each and a classified number of interplanetary ballistic missiles. Mass effect fields keep the gravity in its installations at a comfortable level for long-term living. Hmm. I wonder if these Alliance spaceports are in trouble. What are these naval bases? We have to rescue somebody, don't we?
Launch detected. Report to hazard shelters immediately. Repeat. Javelin Mark II missile launch detected. Report to hazard shelters immediately. Launch detected.
Launching probe.
Launch detected. Report. Report to hazard shelters immediately. Scans detect an Alliance colony defended by a Javelin MK-2 missile base. A distress signal indicates that the base is compromised by Batarians who have launched two missiles at the Alliance colony. Total destruction of colony is imminent. Those Batarians. Zero probability of survivors of missile strike. Find the control panel in the Javelin Mark II missile base. Time of impact calculated. Landing party will have 5 minutes to deactivate the missiles after shuttle touchdown. Great. Well, let's see if there's any elements. Wow, that's a large spike of iridium there. Well, let's go back around to the flag and we'll know we're done. Yeah. You know, we have 5 minutes. Done with the system. Let me just save. Just in case. Alright, so Jacob's loyal now. Pull field. I think I'll bring him. And Samara. Alright, I've got stuff. I want to save my points. I want to change the stasis to something else. I forgot. No points available. Throw field. Nothing. Okay. Let me just see what he's using. Viscerator shotgun. Yeah. Okay. Oh my. That's a mighty big warhead there, Mr. Batarian. These guys are always up to no good.
Warning. Two missiles are approaching.
Looks like a firefight. Not sure how long ago.
Oh, crap.
This should take the heat off.
I'm being really bold because there's not a lot of time here. Oh! Didn't even realize there was another one there. Can't go that way? I got time. Oh crap. Is time still going while I'm doing this? Where is it? That was obscuring my view.
Heads up.
No good.
Neutralize one. Get them off their feet.
Nothing's gonna hurt me now!
Undercover. Nothing's gonna hurt him now!
Put them where we need them.
All running out of time over here. That'd have been smart if she's telling me to get down.
Throwing up a barrier!
Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh, I fell. Yeah. I'm so frantic because I'm trying to get through in time. Okay. I'd have to be a little
looks like a firefight.
More careful.
Warning. Two missiles are approaching target. I'm transmitting a countdown to you.
Incendiary ammo, please.
This will occupy them. Scored a hit.
There's another guy back there, isn't there?
Nothing's gonna hurt me now.
I'm gonna hurt you now. Oh, that's right, it's bound this way. Well, we're making better time right now. Makes me feel better. Can't move. Wait. Ugh. Game, you have to let me go cover. It's not even good cover.
I will hold.
Yeah, please do. I didn't even know that guy was there. He didn't know I was there either, actually.
Nothing's gonna hurt me now!
He's done. We gotta get over to that thing.
I've got no shields.
Oh, boom.
Barriers up.
Where do I go now? Can I save? I can't save. Someone's taking cover.
Damn it.
Is that Jacob? Where do I go? I'm wasting time now.
Barriers up!
Barriers up. That's a dead end. This way? Okay. I messed it up. I hate time limits in games. I really do. Oh, it's making it easy for me because I failed it. My god. Alright, guys, help me out here.
That should take the heat off.
Is it just him?
gonna hurt me now!
Kill switch console. Let's do this first. Amber, and then a little of that, and then green. I think I passed one. Come on, guys. Come on, come on. No, damn it. That wasn't it.
There is only one remaining kill switch code. Therefore, only one missile can be stopped. Use the kill switch code to save your selected target.
What? Apply kill switch to protect alliance interests and tactical viability. Save the city hundreds of lives. I'm saving the city. Yep.
We did it.
Hate that I had to choose, actually, but... That was hairy. Hold up to end the mission. There might have been something we missed. There's power cells over there. You know, it's funny, I don't remember finding any heavy weapon ammo, not for quite a while. Maybe I'm full and I can't hold anymore? Oh crap, that scared me. That's not something I can blow up. Okay. Which is F. Yes. I did a melee. Prevented Batarian radicals from destroying colony on Franklin. Protected colony's residential core. Thousands of lives saved. I suppose he didn't say anything about I should have defended the, well, I guess he doesn't care about the Alliance, does he? Got 125 experience, 7,500 credits, 2,000 palladium. Bloop. Alright, do we have a message?
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
She must say that in her sleep. From Leslie. I am Leslie. I was on Aea. The food made me sick. The doctors are helping me now. One doctor knows Jacob. He says he can tell you this. He could write this for me, but I want to do it. I need to use my words. My words are coming back. I can talk well. Reading is hard, but I am getting better. I have to get better. Taylor wanted me like this. He wanted my words gone. I have to show him that he lost. I am not weak. He did things to me, and he can't now. He can't take away my words. He can't make me not weak anymore, because you and Jacob stopped him. Thank you, Leslie. Right, so... referencing the mission we did last episode. Jacob's loyalty mission. It was pretty interesting. His father's a scumbag. Okay, so we've got the chorus. Might as well get some more probes. We used a lot of them, right? Okay, so there's only one more system. Let's just look at this one planet. And we'll call it an episode. Lena, which means cloaked, is a methane-clouded hothouse planet. Its lack of a metal-rich core and significant magnetosphere allows for an easy scan, which reveals mining equipment on its surface. It can be deduced that this mining occurred within the last 5 years. Any longer and the machines would have been worn down to nothing by the excessive heat and dust storms of hot iron oxide. Rich in deposits. Only want some element zero here, if there is any. With stuff like this, my mouse tends to run off the mouse pad. That's it. No Ezo here. Okay, so next episode we'll go to Sanctum to disable the false signal. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, go strong.